My name is Panakshi. I'm a software engineer with Intuit, where we strive to power prosperity around the world by developing various financial solutions for small businesses, as well as mid-level enterprise organizations. And to achieve that, one of the main goals that we have is that we reduce latencies when it comes to communication between services, while ensuring that all the connections are they have the proper security in place. So we strive for security and reduce latencies. And a step in that direction was the architecture where we have put our north-south gateway on service mesh. And what that essentially means is that any traffic that is coming from the gate from the internet is actually those connections terminate their TLS on the Istio proxy that is running beside this gateway container, and any connections here on after are actually MTLS based. So it actually solves both the latency as well as the security problem, but it actually resulted in causing some issues on our platform. And the issues were that as we all know, in most organizations, a gateway is eligible to call all the services that are there in that organization, which is the case with Intuit as well. And because of that, we had to bend out all those Istio configurations, the service entries, the destination rule, virtual services, of all these services that are running inside Intuit to these gateway pods. Even though the gateway application itself was sharded, what that means is that a single instance of gateway was eligible to call only a subset of services. But we were bending out the configuration for everything because mesh was not aware that gateway in itself is sharded. Along with that, we started seeing another error, which is called UH. I think a couple of folks here would have seen this, which stands for no healthy upstream. And we started observing this when new gateway pods were coming up, because we were vending out so many Istio clusters to this gateway proxy that some of them were not getting resolved by the time Istio proxy actually got ready and started receiving those requests. So those resulted in 503s with the UH response flag. Along with that, even our cost was going through the roof, because Istio D was doing a lot of cross-AZ data transfer to actually push these Istio configurations to all the Istio proxies. The Istio proxy was holding that many configurations, so obviously the memory utilization there was also high. And as I mentioned, the DNS was also processing so many requests, so the cost was going high for the DNS utilization requests as well. So how that looked like on the cluster level was, let's consider a scenario where shard 1 is actually calling service B and shard 2 is calling service A. But in this case, Admiral, the global control plane component that we use at Intuit, was actually vending out the Istio configurations for both the services to both the shards, that is represented by the small blue and yellow boxes. And this obviously was not useful, because shard 1 was never going to call service A, and similarly for shard 2. So to optimize this and to unlock the efficiency there, the solution was pretty simple, that the gateway workloads were actually annotated with the shard identity. Earlier, they had just single identity. Both the shards had a single identity, which was the north-south gateway. Both of them were referring just that identity. But now we annotated them with the shard identity, which meant that Admiral now was aware that, okay, this is the workload that is responsible as shard 1, and is going to call only a subset of services. So what Admiral could do now was calculate the export to for the specification of all those service entries, destination rule, virtual services, and the value would be equivalent to the namespaces of the shard where this configuration actually has to go to. What that meant was that the load on Admiral also reduced, because now it didn't have to write this configuration on all the gateway clusters, but only on the gateway cluster where the responsible shard was, and also only to the namespace with help of the export to field. And this obviously solved all the issues that we saw earlier, Now every instance of gateway was getting only the configuration for the 25 or 30 services that it was actually responsible for. There was no useless configuration that we were vending out there. The DNS resolutions were also limited, so we saved on the cost there as well. And there were no UH errors. Those UH errors were completely eliminated. And because Istio-D was pushing less cross-EZ data transfer, was less cross-EZ data transfers was happening because it was pushing less configuration, the Istio proxy's memory utilization also reduced. So we were able to actually calculate the new resource allocations for all the proxies and save a lot there. That's it. So in this way, we were able to ensure that if a certain platform is shard aware, then Mesh also accepts that, and it does that seamlessly so that any service that is not sharded keeps running as is, but any platform that is actually sharded has the ability to come onto Mesh now. Thank you. Please check out the Admiral repository. It's open source. Would appreciate any contributions there. That's it. Thank you. Any questions?